Welcome to Energy FM.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Tanan. And thank you for having me. Thank you for having
you're
me.
You're very, very much welcome. No? So, I know you're so busy. No, medyo nalangan kay kagamay because I posted nga itong you're coming for 9:30.
Oh, sorry.
No? It's okay, it's okay.
Sorry, no? Sorry.
I know you're so busy. That's why I was thinking, siguro basiga, kaya natin ako pungutan na nimo. Can I ask?
Of course. You know, you can ask me anything.
That's right. Ma'am, salamat kayo. No? Of course, si Ma'am Margot Osmeña, former Cebu City South Councilor, and we all know she's the better half of the former Cebu City Mayor, Tommy Osmeña.
Basta I'm not the former wife, huh? Tanan, former, basta dili ko former wife.
Okay. Okay. Pero ito, siguro on, ma'am, ganyan na dili ka dyan. Ang makakuha na si Mayor Tommy, ito, suntihan na lang yun. So, Madam Margot, no, of course, no, Cebu City's ma'am, Margot Osmeña, Mayor.
Yes.
Buangan, ako yung nag-text na ako, ni comments on Facebook, mato siya nga, ingon siya nga, kanang pangutan araw ko si Madam Margot, kung kisa ko tinood nga, ma'am, siya ba, or si Mike ba?
Ako, babae ba yan ko? So, mother, man.
Dahil na siya, kung mag-ma'am siya, lalaki siya. Madam Margot, no, to the question right now, no, first, ako siya pangutan.
Yes, go ahead, please.
Of course, no, kaninga, kung magod, madam, doon ako yung mga pangutan, nga, kaninga, it's about you and then si Mayor Tom, question related. So, number one, ako nga question, ma'am. Kaning, daghan naman takag chance, ma'am, nga mudagan pagka mayor in the past. But Mayor Tom, no, ni-give voice siya ni Alvin Garcia, former mayor, and now Mayor Mike Rama. Ganong karon pa man, ma'am, nga naka-decide ka nga mudagan?
Good question. Bisag ako manggod na ako sa akong kaugalingon nga naman karon pa na senior na ko sa kaniadto, even the time na I think that was 2010 yun katong humana ang 3 terms ni Tommy, so wala na siya kadagan, but he had promised Mike that he would be the one who would run for BOPK. At that time dunay mga kapitan out of the 80 na kadawat ko og petition signed by 65 of them na kung pwede ako ang mudagan instead of Mike. Maybe because na naanad sila ni Tommy ang ilang pagtanaw kanako extension. Maybe, I don't know, but I remember klaro kaayo na si Tommy nagsaad ni Mike na siya ang magsunod ni Mike. So, Tommy keeps his promises. And then after that, but that same year, nidagan ko 2010, nidagan ko pagka-konsihal. Kay gisulti, I remember si Tommy na surprise because I told him one morning, Tommy, sige, dagan ako. Tanaw siya na ko. And I said, no, konsihal. Para lang hilom na ang mga, kaming mga kapitan ba. Diba? At least, naagyod ko sa konseho. That's how it started. But, sa inyong pangutana, nga naman karon lang ko mudagan pagka-mayor. Maybe, it's time. I didn't choose kay kung sa ambisyon lang, nga naman karon lang, diba? But, para na ko, it's time. Naanad naman ta na magtanaw ta sa mayor, amahan sa atong syudad. Inahan naman.
So, kanisya, Madam Margot, no, kaning, daghang gyud mga occasion before, nga, former Cebu City Mayor Tommy Osmeña, kaning, gave way to you. Nangutaan na ba siya once before? Nga, ganahan magyud ka magmayor?
No.
Not this time.
We don't even discuss that.
Oh, really?
Wala gyud may maghiskot na, okay, sa sunod na election, ana. You know, we don't, our house between us lang. Uh-huh. No, it's very non-political.
Actually, and the most convenient, no, good ma'am, sa mga mayor, no, that's why medyo masyak sila before, muna nga, immediately, inigkahuman sa terminos mayor, ilan nang ipush ang asawa. Because,
asawa, yes, anak, zoon, anak. Oh,
but wala not with Mayor Tom.
Never. And ibisag usara ang among anak, bugtong anak na si Miguel, wala siya mudako na, okay, usa ka adlaw, ika na ang sunod. There is no sense. Hopefully, we were able to put that in him. Walay sense of entitlement.
Or wala maanan ang mga tao, siguro anas at bam na.
Well,
so, madam, no, kaning, yung sama niyo pagsulti ni Mayor Tom, nga, of course, no, we know Mayor Tom, kung unsa iyang nga pamagi ba sa politika, pagpadagan sa atong siyudad. One morning, yung sama niyo pagsulti nga.
One evening.
One evening.
Okay. One evening. ding nagstory-story lang ni Deha, dili lang si Tommy ug ako na mga I think 2 or 3 other people naghisgot na about kay hapit na ba kinanlan mag-file og certificates of candidacy. So I don't know, naminaw lang ko nila, then I just said, what if I run? Tanaw siya na ko. He said, are you serious? I said, no. And then, nangutan na siya, do you really want to run? I said, no. But, nikawas sa akong baba. I don't know why, but nikawas good. And then, that's it.
Kasi tanaw niya mo siya, now, happy siya or na-goal siya or na-shock
surprise.
Siya? Surprise.
Surprise. But, slowly siguro, it became, why not? Hindi ba? Nga naman,
on that same evening, he answered, why not?
No. No, not on the same evening. Parang everybody was trying to absorb, even me. I said, nga naman, nigawas na sa akong baba.
Gawa, what have I done?
Correct. Up to now. But again, I don't come in. I am not, I have come into this journey. Full.
Once again, mga bayan, in case you just tune in, we have right here in the house, no, si Cebu City's Ma'am Margot Osmeña, Mayor, with us right here sa itong programa nga Kanta Historia. Ma'am, kanisya nga pangutana, no? If elected mayor, no, knowing you have the most qualified, di ba? Nobody will ask that, no? Yung experience, no? Most experience, labaw sa tanan, ma'am. Your most loyal nga alay, imong bana, di ba?
Of course.
Now, I question, what's my role ni...
He's my husband. He will always be my husband. Forevermore. Okay, what's his role? Of course, I will ask him for advice. Like you said, kinsa pa mas qualified niya? Could he, you know, other mayors have asked others for advice. You see what happened.
That's right.
Number one, si Tommy, why agenda ka na ko? He's my husband. I'm his wife.
Most loyal ally.
Yes, and he was the mayor. And makasabot naman mo tingali kung makasulti gyud ko para nako, he was the best mayor we ever had. So why shouldn't I ask him for advice? Ikatulo, libre no ang consultation.
Is it advantage?
Dili lang 24/7, take home pag yun.
Right, pastor.
Kasi makasulti ana, right?
That's right.
Right, I mean... I think
hipokrito sa kami nga, no, he will just be sitting in one corner.
No, I will not say that.
As
because I highly respect him and I make no excuses for being his wife.
Madam Margot, no, kaning mamutan ako ba right after if elected ba, no, sa ingling ko din mo sa opisina, unsa mag ipinakauna gini mong buhaton mga magkapa sa atong pandemic, and of course, no,
which one, the pandemic,
yeah, sa udet and everything sa atong ekonomiya. I think kana siya ba yung aside ang first day lang gini mo, what's your first step?
You know, I've said this before and I will say it again. We have to look at what we have. That's the first thing I always do in any job or any task that I am given. Tanawa lang nako, what do we have to help us with this task? So in this case, look at our resources. What are our resources? Number one are the people in City Hall. Because there are many good people in City Hall who want to do a good job. I would like to make that very clear. And all they want to do is to do their job. And it's not us that they do more than their jobs. Because if they just makatrabaho lang sila sa unsay gi-expect nila, then that's good. Number one, I will look at those resources. Number two, what's the money that we have? Or that we don't have? Excuse me. And napabay mga utang. Nga naman ang uban nga serbisyo na naapektuhan na ba? Why? Because we did not pay? Why haven't we paid? Right? Is it because we have no money? Or we have used the money for other things? Do we have too many of this? Do we have too little of that? Those are the things I would like to look at. In other words, Mon, ang akong tanawon, what we have. Dili ko mangita sa what we don't have and then make excuses.
That's right.
Meanwhile, life goes on. I cannot say, time sa, kay naglimpyo pa ko sa balay. No, life goes on. I am very blessed and I'm very grateful that ang pamilya sa BOPK, the team, we have experts. We have those who can focus on the other things that I cannot focus on at the moment. We are a team. The Vice Mayor is Franklin Ong. Anad man siya, hindi ba? Atubang sa mga barangay. Ang mga problema comes from each barangay. So he can address that. And I have the other, those who are councilors. They can help. We are there as a team.
Yes. So, Ma'am Kalinga, how do you rate, paraton ka ba? From a distance ba? Kung sa may mong rating, Ma'am, sa current administration, sa ilahang COVID-19 response from a distance, from day
very
one.
Very hard from a distance.
Sige na, tayo rate no, from 1 to 10.
From day one?
Yes, ma'am.
Very hard to tell. But from day one, 3. I don't even want to put any numbers in it. But remember, this is what I remember, Mon. Sige lang sila magsulti, naghambog pag yun. Na ayaw lang kabalaka. Don't get worried. Don't be sad because we are the most prepared city in the Philippines to face COVID. We are number one. Unya na number one ba yata sa COVID?
Number
remember?
One sa COVID.
And then we had different barangays, Barrio Luz, Barrio Mambaling. They were cited, right? And what did the government do? They put them on lockdown. And then they sent tanks. Tanks. Remember?
Yeah.
You mean the tanks can kill the COVID? What was happening there? Ang mga tao, hapit na mamatay sa gutom. See? So if you're going to ask me, I don't even want to put numbers because maybe I cannot put a number.
Zero.
Yeah, maybe. But eventually, of course, as we learned, I mean, I'm not, you know, it was hard in the beginning, I know that. But because what is COVID? That was the first time we heard of COVID pandemia. But again, we have to look at the people.
Ma'am, sa imo nga evaluation, no? You know, I have seen a big billboard diya sa may south. Kita ako diha, ma'am. Doon ay picture ni Mayor
Tommy.
No, Mike Rama and Vice Mayor Ontiveros. Ingon sila, ma'am, nga okay na, we are now back, we are now free. Kanang okay na ang tanan, bantay lang. So may kasulti mo na mo, what do you think? Kasi
it's free
mayor.
Advertising.
Okay.
Plus, okay. Naaman siya yung mga lain in almost every sitio in the barangays. Katong monitoring, who's supposed to monitor that? Karon lang. And then there are other billboard, I mean, they're made of wood, you know? They're very, you know, yung mga bantay lang mo warning us about COVID. So what is it? Are we free or they're warning us? And why is there monitoring? Isn't that, di ba, maglibog ta sa ilang mensahe, lain-lain. Pero klaro ka ayo, nagbayad niya na ang City Hall.
So, sa ito pa, kanang pag-announce nila, ma'am, nga, pagpahibaw nila na ito, nga, we are now okay, we're now back to normal, wala na ang COVID, some sort of saying.
And then,
like
na-monitoring.
No? Na-monitoring. So, meaning, in short, you don't believe na we are now.
I'm confused. Ayan.
That's right, the word.
I am confused. Naglibog. Maybe I'm not the only one confused. Usay mensahe, ani. O niya, magbasa ko sa, free naman ta. Oh, the other one, bantay ta. The other one, monitor. Kisa mag-monitor, ana.
By the way, no, atong mga late tuners, in case you just tuned in, we have atong kauban nga rikaroon sa atong storya, no, sa atong kanta story niya, si Cebu City's mom. Okay, so Margot Osmeña, mayor, sa atong nga, ni Paigatabay nga, ni uban si Madam Osmeña na itong rikaroon sa atong programa. Ma'am Margot, no, kaning, despite sa promise, ma'am, sa atong current administration with the councilors, bitano nga, ingon sila, ma'am, nga, gani, nisaad sila nga, doon na nakunotay nga, watay problema sa water supply ko, no, this coming by October, tungod na nga project, ma'am, sa Lusaran. Okay? So, despite of this promise, o sa ilang plano, makaingon, baka ma'am, can you still anticipate nga doon natin future water supply problem in Cebu City?
I anticipate that. But you know that Lusaran project, I really hope it pushes through because it will help. you know, it doesn't mean that because I'm on the other side na
correct
that I will always oppose. Yeah. For what is it is good. If it is good, if we can do it, why not? If given the chance to be able to sit there, if it is, we will continue it. Right? So, I will not say, okay, no. If it's good, it's good.
What about kaning kuan ma'am, sa waste to energy?
Wala klaro man.
You think maka solve din ma'am sa itong kuan, itong garbage disposal problem? And also sa itong power supply shortage nga sa Cebu City?
Okay, one by one, no?
Okay.
Ang sa waste to energy, everybody wants to, likes that project. And I remember, sa panahon ni Tommy pa, ang dun ay, I think it was ADB who funded the feasibility studies, and they helped because there were mga lain-lain proponents who were offering their waste to energy services. So ADB helped free. They funded it themselves, and they suggested, no? And there were some kasi they found whatever reasons inefficient or not applicable. But then of course you know what happened so 2019. So wala madayon. But then this one that they were discussing, if I remember correctly, did not even have a place where they were going to put their facility.
So if elected mayor, you will push through the
we will review.
Review.
We will give
innovate.
You.
Innovate.
Of course we will give you to see that.
But,
we will give you.
But basically, ang kanisyang waste energy is viable to you sa inyong
depends what the energy is. Again, we have seen the environmentalists, hindi ba, decry the
yes,
the effects.
Yes.
You know, again, may I bring it up? I'm very lucky that I have people in our BOPK group who I can depend on. I'm not the expert, but I can ask Councilor Nestor Archival to help, hindi ba? He is not only an environmentalist, he walks the walk and talks the talk. So he can help. See?
And then, Ma'am Margot, no, what do you think? What can you say kay Matod Panila? Stoppable man siya, no? But it's going on right now na ang carbon modernization project. What do you think?
There is nothing but we are objecting to as far as modernization is concerned. Nalipay gyud ko naman na nang nigawas karon. Kay they're always saying that what they are missing is the privatization part. Why does it take a private company to modernize carbon? Why can't the city do it itself? And to make it into a world class, I don't think we're expecting it to be a world class. Carbon is the market that so identifies Cebu.
Yes.
And kinsay nangompra diha, those with limited budgets, right? And ang private ba, syempre if you're in business, you're in business to make money. You're not in business to give away. So, Megawide is a private corporation. And it is within their very nature and their DNA to be in business to make a profit. Right?
So, madam,
so ang dato, mas madato, ang mga pobre, samot.
Kaya some people said kuno nga kani kuno ng carbon niya murag mo compete na lang kuno sa grocery kuno sa mga dagko like SM and Gaisano.
Correct.
So kato siyang atong idea impression of a carbon public market, the smell, the prices, the people around, di ba kato mangyaka lang itaw sa Dublin from backyard nga mga products, di ba? Will all be gone. Is that correct, madam?
Then it's no longer carbon market. Why call it such? Then carbon is such, it has its own identity. Take away the smell. You know, I'm sure. I mean, if it's bothersome, take it out. I mean, but does it have to be, like, demolished? Don't take out the nature, the identity. You can improve on it,
so,
but don't take it out.
So, Mom, if elected mayor,
we will review.
Do something about that.
Of course.
So first, mahitabo na, it will be stopped. The modernization.
Yes, until it is reviewed. Number one, remember, it was passed through the council very hurriedly. In fact, then Vice Mayor Mike Rama said, wait, there has to be corrective measures done. And it was admitted by the members of the council na wala sila time na magbasa sa tibuok JVA or the Joint Venture Agreement. But still, it was approved. How can you approve something that significant without reading? Right? You're not doing your job. What's one more week? Nga naman kinalang i-approve na yun.
Masin dali.
Why dali? Correct. Why not wait 1 week?
Para dali.
Ay. Masay dali. Para sa unsa.
Dali ang public service, di ba?
Ngang.
Masin madam. So, kanina, naghatag mga nakita, bitaw nga kanina, after sa bagyo nga si Odette, mga Margot, no? Kanina, kaya mga alampre sa itong mga skid-kilid, what do you think as later on when you sit down as mayor, if elected, are you bothered with this virus around?
I remember, it's bothersome. It's very, because it's ugly, di ba? And it could be a hazard.
That's why I ask you this question. Kay ang mga lalaki nga mga mayor, tanaw na kung maragwam siya, particular ang maragwapa, itsura itong siyudad mayor, di ba?
Yeah, ugly.
I really want to ask you about this because I'm sure, kanyang mga babae, mga good news na that, they can really see kung unsay gwapa, unsay dili.
Yeah,
any
yes.
Any major plan, ana, siya?
Okay, doing that, the city cannot do that. We have to have the cooperation of the utility companies, of those who have those wires there. I think, you know, I'm sure they're willing to help. Just have to talk to them and talk to them as equals. You know, ask them, okay, this is what we want. This is the same city you live in, di ba? Nagpuyuman ta diri.
Yeah, all of us.
No, so magtanaw ta, it's the same thing. But how can we as government help you help us? You know what I mean?
So that means to say, Ma'am Margot, wala pa gud ay mga serious talks with the telcos as of now?
Dili gyud ko kahisgotana. No, there was a time that I do remember na we talked to them and then they'll even identify by color kung kang kinsay, let's say Globe or Smart or PLDT or whatever. So that at least sila na lang yung responsible. But you know, you have to keep on. You cannot just say, okay, and then expect it to happen. You have to monitor.
Because the latest I've heard sa council, nga ilalanggi kuan kuno nga from, I think, 16 feet above the ground, ilalanggi pa sa kanga to sa 18. So I was kind of...
The same thing.
Yeah, I was kind of disappointing. Abi na po, ayuhon. Isa ka lang para di masangit itong diog kuno kaya nangatagak naman yun.
Because that takes a lot of money.
That's right.
And we have to convince them also that it is also for their benefit. Right?
Bisan unta, no, ka nang... Kanabang, di lang yun ta mag-expect nga tanang lugar sa Cebu City, but probably they could pilot a project siguro in some area.
I was going to say that.
Diba? At least,
mag-pilot ta. Oh, posible pala. Okay, sunod. Next.
Like that.
Yeah. Huh? I mean, I cannot say na, I mean, I will not go in there and say, okay, in 365, the whole city. No. We have to all know where we're coming from and where we want to go.
By the way, once again, no, we have here sa atong kanta istorya karong mga bayan, no, si Cebu City's Ma'am Margot Osmeña, Mayor, joining us sa atong kanta istorya. Madam, what can you say about our bike lanes? What do you think?
I know that it's a...
Do we have a bike lane?
I was going to ask that. Where? Where are the bike lanes? I mean, it's so easy to say, okay, there's an ordinance, right? So that's a law.
That's right.
That we have to have bike lanes, but you kind of look, tanaw lang ka, asa nang bike lanes?
Na bala ka magud ko kay nakadungog ko sa mga sa bike lane board, they're doing another task naman, murag nag-distribute naman sila mga discount cards nga na kung trabaho sa so, in your administration reflected, Ma'am Margot, what will you do with the bike lanes?
Let's do it again the same way, pilot.
Okay,
let's start with the pilot, hindi ba? And then you have to get the bikers themselves involved. Government cannot tell them. Yeah. They should tell us. Not tell us, but share with us what they expect. See? And then you cannot just say, okay, that's a bike lane. And then all the rest, it's a coordinated effort and it has to be integral to the whole traffic system.
As of now, ako'y punta, I think we don't have a bike lane.
No, none.
Wagit ta. Ma'am Margot, no, kani siya. Si Mayor Michael Rama, ingon siya, ibalihin ko nun niya ang sinulog ko nung Grand Parade ba to or the whole sinulog event sa SRP. What can you say?
That's fine. As long as we can do it, yeah, that's fine.
Okay lang.
Yeah, mm. Yes. See, I don't have to disagree with everything. That's fine. As long as we can do it.
Margot, no? Kanisya, gusto nga ipangutanan yung mga question ba? Like, we know very much, no? Si Mayor Tommy Osmeña, and then from everybody, ma'am, from head to foot, no? Because we really know him. He's so vocal, unya, kung kanang masuko siya, ma'am, suko siya, no? Kita-kita niya ba everything? And how he works also, no, for Cebu City. Siguro doon ay mga nalipay, nasa mga nalipay. Now I will ask you, ma'am Margot, no? Ma'am, if elected sa pagka-mayor, ma'am, unsa man kay imong buhaton, ma'am, nga kanang atong malupigan si Mayor Tommy Osmeña?
Very hard. I have to admit, Tommy as a mayor is a very hard act to follow because I'm his wife, so I know him. What you know is what you see. But you know, sukad-sukad pa, pag-abot na ako diri, and you can see clearly that I am not a native. I was not born and raised in Cebu City, kay hangtod karon ang akong Bisaya yung it, but never mind. That doesn't matter. But as Tommy, as I was with him and he was first mayor, there was something that really, really struck me. I have never had, wala man ko higayon or wala yun ko, ano na, rason ba, na magselos ko, no, sa mga babae. Wala yun. But there was something that Miguel and I learned and that we, kung wala mi kompetensya ni sa kasing-kasing ni Tommy, naagyod ni kabahin. Why do I say that? Because he really loves Cebu City. Only Cebu City. Why do I say that? Kay kapila na mga higher ups in government would ask him, dagan ka, Senator, like this, we will appoint you as secretary of so and so. And like you said, si Tommy magsulti, no. Very frank, no. No. So one time, nangutana ko niya, Tommy, why? Sige lang ka magbalibad. I was just curious. Then he said, because I hate politics. You hate politics? You hate politics? But you're mayor. You know what he said? Very clear. Very Tommy. Because I love Cebu City. See?
But he hates politics.
But he really loves Cebu City. And I've seen that. We travel. He sees a new kind of light. I remember that in the parking lot. Who knows where? I forget. Now you say, take a picture of that light. That's good for Cebu City. I brought here the first sodium light. I was in America visiting my siblings. He calls me and he says, Margot, you go to the hardware store and you buy a sodium light. I said, what's a sodium light? Then he said, just tell them. And then he gave me the specs. I brought it home. It was so big. And he had it installed there, in Puente Osmeña, near Robinson's. That was the first sodium light. See, he doesn't stop. We were in Singapore once and then we visited the police. I don't know. Then he saw in one of their rooms in the police station, na yung mga signs, yung mga street signs, do not walk, or cha-cha-cha, or right turn only. And he said, what are you doing with those? And then they said, nothing. Can I please have them? See? He doesn't stop. And he sees a new idea. He says this, I'll try this. He's not annoying. Maybe that's an asset and maybe it's a liability on his part. That when the moment he has something in his mind, he is so focused. Bahala na mo diha. Even you insult him, does not care. I'm sorry for the critics who think that that their words keep him awake at night. No, he sleeps very soundly. Because if they think that he thinks, how unsaumik pagbawi, Tommy doesn't think like that. He really doesn't. That's why I look at him. He's still around. Mind very clear.
You have to take kasi imong matabata if you become mayor, no? Kasi imong sa imong sidekick diha, grab di.
Yes.
Di ba? Mag-putan ako ba? Was there a time good one again day time nga? Or selos ka gamay nga night chicks ni Dool.
No, wala. Magkakita ba ko I said, Tommy, remember, ha? Huh? You married me before you were mayor.
Ikaw may first naka-discover niya. Pero wala yung time, ma'am. Nga nang mura, surrounded sa mga chicks, mga inana, o niya, you got, wala dyan, no?
Wala.
Pero atong balihon, si Mayor Tom, was
wala,
there a time nga siya po yun?
I don't know. Mangutan na kanila. I don't think so. I think we're very secure. Because number one, si Tommy, he doesn't lie eh. Wala siya mamaka. So, you know, with me, and he's not, you know, daghan mga tao ba, magtuog yun na he's hard, you know? He must be hard to get along with, di ba? Man, he's very simple at home. Very simple person.
We can
person.
Tell by the way you look.
Yes! Siya magluto, o.
Yeah, I know that.
Bana na magluto para ni mo.
Pero ikaw magluto sa gamam sometimes.
No.
Siya good.
Sige.
Ano technique diyan?
No, kay mas lami pa niya siya magluto.
Mom, van.
And ganahan siya. Ako, di ba ko ganahan?
Ganahan ka mukha. On siya yung luto.
Oh, and then he would even ask me, oh, what do you want today? Ato?
Mura restaurant diyan.
You know, bisag ka tong panahon na we were abroad, kay nagpatambal siya, remember? Sa iyang cancer. So there were times na sa iyang chemotherapy, 4 days man to straight. Uh-huh. Not like the others na in and out, na out. No, he's his inpatient. 4 days straight chemotherapy. Isog kaayo. Knowing that, bago siya mag-check-in sa hospital, we rented an apartment not near the hospital. He will cook for me. Because 4 days daw, wala ko'y pagkaon. Oh, see?
Kuya kaysa, ma'am. Kasi uyab. Kuya kaysa.
Kuya. No, really. So, yeah.
Ma'am Margot, finally, I will ask you this question. No?
Go.
Para sa mga Cebuano na minaw karon, of course, they have this question. No, nga. Alis tulo magukabok ang fight karon, di ba? Si Mike, you and Dave tumulak. Ma'am, at listening, namino ko ato mga Cebuano, ato mga listeners, especially ato mga drivers, ato mga construction workers, ato mga listeners, no? Kaning, tell them straight, kuno, why vote for you instead of Mike or si Dave?
Hindi ko ganahan.
They're all your friends, I'm sure, I know, no? Right now, no? Like,
because Cebu needs a mom. Sige lang, naanad na ta na ang atong mayor amahan. So, we lang inahan. I am providing an alternative. I will not put down the people running for the same position. But, number one, I was never suspended. You know?
One time you were acting mayor, I remember.
Mayor Doma. I like to call myself that. Kay 6 weeks lang man to. So, when they would say, Mayor, I'd say, Tili ko mayor, kay walang yun na butar na ko pagka mayor. Mayor Doma lang ko. See? I mean, I can take things that way. Again, why me? Because I am asking for a chance to be an alternative and see it in the eyes of a woman. Especially from the heart. I've read this and I will say it now. Half of the sky is held up by a woman. Give that half.
Luhay kayo mga lalaki, no? Once again, mga bay, no? Cebu City's Mom, M-O-N, Mayor, Margot Osmeña, Mayor. Madam, thank you very much for the time.
Yes, and I'd be happy to come back.
Okay?
And I'd be happy to come back.
Thank you very much once again. See you, Mayor.
Thank you.
See you, Mayor.
Thank you.
Margot Osmeña, Mayor.
Margot Osmeña, 9.